Hey guys, it's me, Morpheus. It's Carlos. How are you guys today? Today what I got for you guys is going to be just a quick unboxing and a quick run through of my new product here. It's actually a Sprint Overdrive 3G, 4G mobile hotspot. It's pretty much a Wi-Fi router. I mean, this thing is awesome. I've already taken it out of the box. I did configure it. It's all web-based, super easy to work. This is it, guys. This is the size of this thing. I was so surprised when I saw it. It does have a little micro USB. I do have a 1 gigger in there. With the 1 gig, check this out. You can have 5 people connect to this thing, and all 5 people can shoot data over to your data card, pull data off, if I allow them to, because there's a separate password to get into the data card on here. But let me just go ahead and pop this out. In the box, you definitely get, you know, the card itself, little direction booklet, English and in Spanish. You get, you know, USB so that you connect it to the power, AC power, USB. And you also get the USB cable, which I don't have here. I actually have it hooked up to the computer where I was actually configuring. And this thing is really, really nice, guys. Like, I can connect. I've had this thing across the house and totally connect. It says you can connect up to 150 feet away. Really, 150 feet away. I mean, it's a Wi-Fi router. So let's go ahead and kick this on. There we go, it's turning on. It's got a 1.4 LCD display, a built-in GPS. You can see how small and compact this is compared to the iPhone. It's about the same thickness as an iPhone with a case on it. And it's just a little bit wider than an iPhone. So, I mean, for you to take this and slip this into a bag, throw it into your back pocket, and know that you can provide Wi-Fi for yourself and for 4 other users, awesome, awesome product. I've been a user of Sprint data for the data plan since 2003-2004. I went from a PCI card to a USB card, and now we're moving over to the, you know, the 3G 4G network. Now it is booting up right now, as you can see. It is a little bit of a fingerprint magnet, by the way. I got something to take care of that. I'll show you guys a little bit later on. So it is booting up right now. Come on, come on, come on. And what it's gonna do, it's gonna look for the 4G network, because I actually have it set up to look for 4G first. That's my preferred network. If it doesn't find 4G, it'll go right over to 3G. I actually also have the LCD to shut off after 30 seconds, you know, to conserve battery life. It says it'll go 6 hours constant use on battery, which is 1800 milliamps. And then it'll go to 40 hours of standby. So it's searching for 4G, didn't find 4G, and now we're connected to 3G. There we go. So it's booted up and it's ready to go. And you can see the name of my network there, kind of like my airport. Over here, we have your signal strength. Over here, we have what we're connected to. Here's how many users, none, no users right now. And over here is our battery life. That's pretty much it. Let me go ahead and take the iPhone real quick. Take the iPhone. You guys know how this works. Go over here. We'll go to Wi-Fi. We'll turn it on. And there it is. There's my Sprint network. Click it on. And that fast, we're actually, there it is. It just beeped over here. And now it's telling me that my iPhone 3G, AT&T 3G, is actually hooked up to, let me go ahead and let's go over to TD Bank real quick. And it's actually connected onto this one here. Now this one here is using 3G also, but I love the speeds on a 3G versus AT&T with Sprint. I mean, it's just, I love it. So let's go ahead and take my netbook. Here's my netbook right now, my E1000E. We'll go ahead and boot that up. Let me go ahead and pull this up a little bit. While that's booting up, let's go ahead and open up the MacBook. Take the MacBook and open that one up also. MacBook's already up and running, so let me just come over here real quick. Let me see if I can show you in frame. Right now, I am connected to my Airport Extreme. Let's see if I can show you guys this. So I'm over on my Airport Extreme, and there it is. There's my Sprint Overdrive. Click on a Sprint Overdrive. And that fast, we are switching over to Sprint Overdrive. You just heard the noise down here. You just heard the noise down here on the device itself, because now it's saying I have three things online, which is one of them is my netbook here. The other one is my MacBook. The other one is the iPhone. And I've actually had the iMac on here also, four devices on here running all at the same time. Now, just to give you guys just a quick basic, you guys can see the speeds we're talking about here. Let me go ahead over to Safari over here. Let me go ahead over here and open up my Internet Explorer over here. And this is all on 3G, guys. Here we got a couple iPad unboxings already. Let me just go ahead and click on anybody's video here. Here is Apple Soldier. I'll definitely be back to check out Apple Soldier's video in a little bit. Click it. Buffering. Now remind you, I have this one over here going as well. So as we see, Apple Soldier's already booted up over here. We got YouTube coming up over here. I am on, there it is. I'm on my Sprint Overdrive over here as well. So I mean, the claim is you can get five devices all running on Wi-Fi at the same time. And guys, it does. You guys saw the buffer speeds on there. I mean, I can get YouTube videos to play within 5 or 6 seconds of actually clicking on it. Super easy. It's all web-based to actually install this thing. You turn it on, right on the front of the device, it tells you to go to this website. You go to the website and bang, you're actually, let me see if I can bring that up real quick because I really like to show you guys that. We'll go over here to my address bar. Let me just bring this up a little bit. There we go. One device got kicked off, which is the netbook, which shut down over there. I'm still on. There it is, Sprint. So now that I'm back on the Sprint over here, you just heard it beep down at the bottom down here. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to type in Overdrive. And there it is. This is the utility that's built into this Overdrive. This is so super easy. Now I am going to cover up the screen for just a second because I do have my passwords and everything stored on here and you guys will be able to see that. There we go. So now you can see that I have my 4G, my WAN, my Wi-Fi set up. Well, no passwords on here. The only one that shows my password is my device over here because it does show my password to get in and out and the passwords that I actually give someone. So there's a password to actually become administrator so that you can change everything on here. Let me go back to the home. And then there's another password that you would just give anybody, give your friends, give, you know, whoever. You know, what better way to introduce yourself? Like, hey, my name is Carlos. Would you like free Wi-Fi? You know what I mean? How awesome is that? You're in a lunchroom. You open up your laptop. Somebody's going to comment, what, are you online? How are you getting online? It's like, well, boot up your laptop. I'll share my online with you. Give them your password, which is just a simple basic password, so they can get in. I also have another password built in here, so that way they can actually access my data card. They can go ahead, get onto my micro USB card, drop files in, pull files out. This thing is kick-ass. When you're on the 4G network, you are totally free and unlimited. No 5 gig cap, by the way, guys. When you go ahead and use the 3G, you're on a 5 gig cap. All right? Now, on here, it actually tells me, there it is. It says that I've used a total of 83 megabytes on this device. That's 4G and 3G. As you see, I have gotten some 4G. As you can see from here, I have gotten 4G to lock on. There it is, 4G. I have had some 4G experiences. It just depends on where in the house I'm at, how close to a window I'm at. But it says there total, I've used 83 megabytes. And I mean, that's downloading YouTube videos, playing around with all three devices, seeing what the speed tests were like. I mean, this thing is amazing. I really, really like this Sprint Overdrive. And again, it's really small, really compact. One button on the top, that's your sound on, sound off, so that way you can tell when someone logs on. In fact, here we go right here. So this here, the sounds that it'll make, it'll tell you when someone logs on, your internet is disconnected, your Wi-Fi user, somebody joins, somebody left, low battery, and sound details. You know, system details, in case you get an email or something, it'll beep over here and let you know. I'll tell you what, the guys over there at Sprint, there was a girl there, her name is Rebecca. And the manager over there at the Sprint store I went to, his name is Brian. These guys were so super cool. They did not have any in stock. I told Brian I really wanted to have this tonight. Is there anything he can do for me? Let me tell you something. The guy hung up with me, and within 10 minutes, he called me back and says, dude, I have an Overdrive here for you. Come pick it up. And that fast, went over to Rebecca, gave my name, took me off the queue, ran me right through, and you guys saw the Twitter posts. I think at one time I said, I'm getting ready to go get it. Within 15 minutes, I had another Twitter post showing that it was live, active, and running. Guys over there at Sprint, that's why you've had my business since 2003, 2002. The furthest back they can go was actually 2004 on my record, and see that I was still a customer back then. It's now 2010. I love everything there is about the Sprint data cards, guys. I really do. I started out with a PCI card, then I went USB, and now I'm over on their Wi-Fi router slash, you know, Wi-Fi unit. This thing is badass. Micro USB, which I don't like, because now I have to carry around a micro USB, not a mini USB, so I can charge this up. I could charge it up from a wall. I could charge it up right from the computer. Again, it says 6 hours battery life is what I can get out of this sucker. 40 hours of standby time. It's a hotspot. That's what it is. I mean, I can have this in my pocket. Someone can detect it, but it doesn't mean they can get in and use it. The only way they're going to get in and use it is if I give them my password. You know, and the only way you're going to get my password is if you're one of my friends and I allow you to get on my network. Otherwise, you're not going to share any of my 5 gigs. Now, it depends on where I'm at. Again, I have gotten on the 4G network. And when you're on a 4G, it is true unlimited. You know, you can go unlimited all day long. No 5 gig cap. The battery in this, I'm not sure if I, there you go, just disconnected. The battery life on this, it also tells you how much in and out you've been pushing, how long you've been running. You can shut it off here. Hold it and shut it down. And I mean, I've totally always had the best experience. You guys have seen me do live blog TV sessions with my Sprint data card. Yes, Sprint data cards on 3G, not even 4G. Full blown out, you know, blog TV sessions, 80, 90 people in the room, you know, no lag. I mean, these things are really, really nice. 1.4 inch screen, built-in GPS, 6 hours battery life. The battery is rechargeable. Here's the battery back here. Simply click it. There it is. 1800 milliamps. I do believe the claim that you do get 6 hours. I haven't had it long enough to let it run 6 hours completely. Micro USB card. It supports up to 16 gigs. And it's 4G. And I'll tell you what, when I ran a speed test on this under 4G, you can see that it is, yes, 5-10 times faster than I was running on the 3G network. All right, now you guys know it's me Morpheus. It's me Morpheus could not leave the building unless I had some kind of protection for this. And look what they just happen to have on the wall. This here is a gel cover for your Overdrive. I'm actually looking for a leather folio or a hard case, you know, because the silicone's gonna be nice, but to get it in and out of your bag, in and out of your pocket, we know that the silicone's gonna stick. But check it out, guys, really soft silicone. You take it, one button on the top, there it is. Throw it in there, pull the bottom, and now we have silicone protection. You know, some kind of shock absorbent. And if it does hit the ground, down here we got access to the micro USB. Over here we have access to the micro SD card. Still see everything visible. Guys, I don't know what else to say about this damn card. I really, really like it. The experience is awesome. It's fast. Let me go ahead and see if I can change that real quick. Let me go ahead and open this one up, open my netbook up, so that way you guys can see how many users I can get on this thing at one time. It says 5, but I've been only being able to get 4 on here at one time. Let me go ahead and click this over here. There's my Sprint Overdrive over here. Resuming session over here on the netbook. Netbook came back to life. Click it here. There we go. We just heard a beep. That means somebody logged onto the network, which might have been my MacBook. This one over here is already on. There we go. Another beep. Over here means we have more than one user. And then we're going to open up the iPhone, make sure that we are connected. And there it is. Sprint Overdrive. And then, of course, the way I name my Wi-Fi spots. And there we go. It shows right here that we do have 3 users on here. You put in a password, the password's dedicated, you're done, you don't have to install it again. Guys, I really, really like this. Sprint, keep doing what you're doing over there. You guys got awesome product. As far as your phones, I can't say much about it. I've never owned a Sprint phone, but when it comes to data cards, I gotta say Sprint is number one in my book. I'm sorry, guys. I know I'm gonna start some kind of war here. AT&T's faster, Verizon, EVDO's faster. I'll tell you what, I can only talk about my own experience. I've only ever owned Sprint and love Sprint. And again, guys, if you don't believe me, go over to my blog TV. I actually have one session recorded that was live, 90 people in a room, and I did it all with a USB data card from Sprint. I mean, you know, what else can you say? The packaging was really nice. Again, here's the packaging, really nice black box, fingerprint magnet, but who cares? You know, you pull it out, immediately it tells you to go and update your firmware, which was super simple to do. You connect this to the main computer, any one computer, via USB. You open up the terminal, you type in http://overdrive. It takes you to the main page. You're the administrator, you change your password, change your admin name. I mean, it's so easy. I didn't need any directions to do this. Guys, I'll tell you what, if you're out there in the market looking for a data card, I would say go with a Sprint, whether it be the Overdrive or just a 3G standard USB. Their speeds are awesome, they're fast, customer service I've never had a problem with. And even at the store where I went there and personally was with somebody, Rebecca, Brian, thank you guys so much for taking care of me over at the Sprint store over here in Deptford. And think about it this way. This is the way I wound up buying this a couple years ago. I said to myself, I went to the Brigada, I was in the casino, and it was like $30. Actually, it was more like $28 so that I can use the Wi-Fi up in my room. Now, if you go down to the lobby, Wi-Fi is free. But who's going to sit down in the lobby all night, all day to get on the internet? You want to be in your room. You want to be comfortable. And at that price, I mean, let's say I stayed at the hotel for two nights. That itself would have been the data plan. The data plan for this is $50 a month. But for $50 a month, I get everyday usage out of this thing. You see what I'm saying, guys? Sprint, thank you guys so much for putting out the awesome product you do, keeping the network up, keeping it live, keeping it fast. To my users out there, thank you guys so much for sticking around, waiting for this video to be shown. I got something else for you. You know, we're gonna see if we can get a fifth device on here. The fifth device going on here, I think you guys know what it's gonna be. There it is. It's gonna be my iPad. So we're gonna go ahead and do the unboxing on this. It is the Wi-Fi version of the iPad, 32 gig, and I planned on using that with this, so that way I could be totally mobile with that iPad until the 3G version of that comes out. And we'll see if I decide to go with the 3G version versus keeping that one and not having to do a giveaway on it. Hint, hint. Stick around to the channel, guys. We got lots of things happening over here at It's Me Morpheus, all right? Sprint, keep doing what you're doing. Brian, thank you so much. The manager, Rebecca, the consultant over there. You guys were totally fun, easy to deal with, had me in and out the door. No change of the plans other than what I wanted. You didn't try to oversell me anything. Guys, it's me, Morpheus. It's Carlos. As you can tell by my voice, I am excited. I have a new little toy. This is going in the back pocket. In the bag, this thing can actually sit across the house because at 150 feet, I can still catch my 4G network. Guys, it's me, Morpheus. It's Carlos. There you go. There was a quick unboxing run through. First thoughts on my Overdrive. There it is, guys. It's me, Morpheus. It's Carlos signing out. Lots of love. Lots of respect, people. Peace.